Good evening, students. This is Mamun here. We are going to start today intermediate English language course, Unit 3, Unit number Just a Job. So before we start this unit class, here we have some grammar. So what are we going to do? We are going to cover the grammar lesson first. After finishing the grammar chapter, we'll come back to this lesson and we'll start from here. Okay, Ali, you ready? So we're going to grammar. As usually, we'll start with the grammar. We'll finish the grammar reference and then we'll come back to our regular lesson in the unit. Okay, with practices. So if you can see the grammar in the loading, internet is a bit slow today.
That's
taking some time, but it will come. Won't be long. So these are the units we're going to cover, and today we'll study Unit 3. Beautiful. So Unit 1, Unit 2 we have covered, we have studied already. We're going to start from Unit 3. So we are going to start from here, Unit 3. Can you see this page?
Yes, I see.
All right, so this is the grammar reference from our unit-wise from the lesson. So we'll finish this grammar and then we'll go back to the lesson, as I said earlier. As you can see, the present simple, this is present simple. Then we have adverbs of frequency, present continuous. So in present simple, the form is the same for I, we, you, they. You know, we have learned in elementary class, the present simple is pretty much same. So as you can see, I work from 9 to 5 p.m. Subject I, work is a present from a verb, from 9 to 5 p.m. is object. They don't work full time. Where do you work? He, she, it, at, s or yes, and use, does or doesn't in question and short answer as an auxiliary verb. Okay. So it doesn't work at weekends. Where does she live? Do you live in Bristol? Does he have a car? Yes, we do. No, he doesn't. Now, the use, there are some rule on the present simple. I'm going to explain that rule in the use. The present simple is used to express an action that happens again and again, a habit or routine. So what do you mean by that? A action that happens again and again as a habit or routine. Like I go to work by car. So this is an action and that we do regularly.
Yeah.
Okay, again and again. That is when it is a present simple. She calls me every day, a habit, a routine, every day. That is when we use present simple, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Second rule is a fact that is always true. A fact that is always true. To make understand such action, we also use present simple, such as Ronaldo comes from Brazil. So it is a fact, it's a truth. It cannot be changed. So that's when we use the present simple. Ronaldo comes from Brazil. My daughter has brown eyes. Like it's a truth. It's the truth, and that is why we use the present simple. Some more. Number three, a fact that is true for a long time, a permanent state. He works in a bank. I live in a flat. They are also present simple. Okay.
Yeah.
Spelling of he, she, it forms. Most verbs add s to the base form of the verb, like once, eats, helps, drives. When the subject is third person singular, like he, she, it. When with this subjective pronoun, we make sentences with the verb, we add usually s. Wants, eats, helps, drives. Number two, add yes. We also add yes to some verb like that end in ss, h, ch, x, and o. You follow this number two here?
Yes, yeah.
Okay, good. Like kisses, washes, watches, fixes, goes. In this word, we don't use only s, we use yes. Okay. So you have to watch this video again and again, and you know, grab this knowledge. And also, when you do some practices, they will be absorbed anyway. Okay. Verbs that ends in a consonant. Why change the y to ies? Okay, like carries, flies, worries, tries. Okay, any verb that end with consonant, with the last word is alphabet is y, change to ies, like carry. Y is a consonant, okay, and that y become ies, carries. Fly, flies. Worry, worries. Try, tries. You follow?
Yes, I follow.
These are the rule literally we have to know, and you know, and they will be applied in our writing, in our speaking. They will come, we'll come across them in our lesson. Okay. Verb that end in vowel instead of y, that's a consonant, vowel, y, only add s, such as buys, buys, says, plays, enjoys. So this is the ball ending in the bowl, right? Bowl.
Mm-hmm.
U, right? A. As you know, we have there are how many balls are in the alphabet? Can you tell me the balls are? What are the balls are?
Vowels, five.
Yes, five vowels. That's good. What are they?
We have
A.
We have E, O.
Huh.
E, O.
U.
No. We have O, U, E.
Mm-hmm. U.
Yeah, A. U, E.
Mm-hmm.
And I, no, I.
Yeah, that's right. So we got a five balls.
Yeah.
So the but when we see the balls at the last, we before the Y, we use S only. Okay. So this is exceptional.
Yeah.
See the changes here. We add all consonants before the Y, and that's why I S. And before the Y, we have a vowel. That's why we use only S. So, clear about the present simple rules and structure? Good. Now, we learn adverbs of frequency. We often use adverbs of frequency with the present simple. Other class, we have I have explained about the adverbs of frequency. I hope you're clear about that. But today, we're going to learn also. So, in adverbs of frequency, we often use adverbs of frequency with the present simple, like 0% to 50%. We may use ever, rarely, hardly, ever, not often. 50 to 100% start from sometimes, often, usually, and always. So they're the adverb of frequency. Okay. We'll get to know more about them when you do practice. Situation, scenario, and all those things. Okay, number two, they go before the main verb, but after the verb to be. Okay, so this adverb of frequency we can use before the main verb. Like, I usually start at 9. I rarely see pizza these days. They are usually here by now. We are rarely at home at weekends. sometimes and usually can also go at the beginning or the end. Sometimes and usually can also go at the beginning or the end. Sometimes we play cards. Usually I go to bed early. We play cards sometimes. We go to bed early usually. Okay, these are the scenario. We can use the adverbs of frequency. Now, present continuous. From am is are plus verb plus ing. It's a present continuous. So present continuous is a structure of... Yes, Ali, would you like to say something?
No, someone called me, so I cut the call.
Okay, good. So in present continuous, we have subject. Then we have a be verb, am, is, are, be verb, plus ing with verb. That is present continuous structure. Like there are some examples. I'm playing tennis. He's cooking lunch. I'm not enjoying my new job. What's he doing? Where are you living? Aren't you working today? Short answer, are you going to wing by train? Yes, I am, or no, I'm not. Now use, we'll know some rule about the present continuous. The present continuous is used to express an activity that is happening now. Okay, our action that is happening at this moment, like I'm teaching you English. Like I'm teaching you English, it's happening right now. This is present continuous. You are listening to me. Right now, the activity is happening. The class is going on. This activity right now is happening. The fan on the ceiling is running. The activities that is happening right now at the moment is continuous action. The action is continuous, is used in present continuous. Okay. So the activity that is happening now. Don't turn the TV off. I'm watching it. You can speak to Lisa. She's having a bath. Number two, an activity that is not necessarily happening at the moment of speaking, but it's happening around now. That is also can be present continuous. That's for example, I'm taking that book and reading it. I'm doing a French evening class this year. I'm doing a French evening class this year. So often, have you understood the number two, an activity that is not necessarily happening at the moment of speaking, but is happening around now? Like you keep the book open and you just went out somewhere there. When, you know, someone tried to keep the book, one of you can say, don't take the book away. Mr. Ali is reading the book. Okay, he's not exactly reading now, but somewhere near the moment he was reading and he will be reading and he's reading. Okay, that is also used in present continuous. Is that clear to you?
Yeah, clear. Okay. So I see some students try to join us. They couldn't.
Sit. Okay, let's see what's happening. Are they sending us messages? How do you know that?
Yeah, I received.
Okay. Let's see what they're saying. Yeah, it's good. We need them. What's the problem? There shouldn't have any problem. We are in regular. Mustafa. It's regular, it's normal. Fine, again. Okay, I've sent him in the message. I'm sending him the details again that we have used. Okay. So I think he has some technical problem to join. Let him try and join if he has a good luck to. Otherwise, let's carry on what we can do. I cannot do that much, but nothing wrong from our end. All right.
Okay.
Number two, have you understood this point? An activity that is not necessarily happening at the moment of speaking, but is happening around now. Like, don't take that book. Jane's reading it. He's not reading now. Okay? He kept the book open because he was reading and he just went out from the book for some times, but he'll come back and he will start reading again. You know?
Yeah.
Okay, so around, you know, but it's happening around now. Like another one, I'm doing a French evening class this year. So this class he's not doing now. He's going to do end of this year. It's kind of to express now future activities. You know, we can use this one. I'm doing on a French evening class this year. Okay.
Okay. Yeah.
So next one, a temporary activity. Peter is a student, but he's working as a waiter during the holidays. I'm living with friends until I find a place of my own. Okay. When a temporary activity is to understood, is to express, we can use this. Like Peter is a student, but he's working as a waiter during the holidays. During the holidays. I'm living with friends until friends find a place of my own. So these activities are not meant to be that it's happening right now, but it, in general, they're doing that one. Okay. In this scenario, we can use the temporary activity to express. We can use this present continuous. Number four, a planned future arrangement. So if we are planning anything to do in future, for that arrangement, also we can use present continuous, such as I'm having lunch with Glenda tomorrow. So it is something that not we are not doing today, neither we are doing now, but we are going to do it tomorrow. So to express a planned future arrangement, we can use present continuous tense too. Like, I'm having lunch with Glenda tomorrow. We are meeting at one outside the restaurant. Okay? So this is the rules, practice, and something you have to remember, like memorization. Memorize them. There is no other option. And they will come by practice also. So when we do practices in our speaking, in reading, writing from the lesson, they will come to us just to know, you know, so that when we do come across those structure and sentences, we can identify easily this is belongs to present continuous. Spelling of verb plus ing. Most verbs add ing to this base form of the verb. So in present continuous, the verb usually have ing form, like go, ing, going, where, wearing, visit, visiting, eat, eating. All right. Next one, what we have. Okay. Verbs that end in one, E, lose the E. So say smoke. Any verb that ends with one E. And when we add ing, we lose that E. Like smoke. S-M-O-K-E, smoke. When we make it ing from E, we lose. We eliminate the E. Become smoking. Likewise, coming, hoping, writing. All of them has a E at the end of the word. So we eliminate that word E and alphabet E. We add ing. Okay? Like smoking, coming, hoping, writing. But lie, L-I-E, lie. Lying. In this one, we also do the same thing. See, here, instead of IE, we make it Y. So this is exceptional. You have to remember, verb that ends in double E, don't drop an E. When the verb has a double E, it doesn't end the E. See, agree has a two E. In this time, we don't eliminate the E. We keep the E because it has a two E, like agree, seeing. Okay? They're very exceptional word. Just keep points. Good. Number three rules, verbs of one syllable with one vowel and one consonant, double the consonants. Like stop. Stop. It has a, at the end, it has a one consonant and also it has one vowel, right? So when verb that has one consonant at the end, one vowel at the end, we double up the last, double the last alphabet, and then we add ing, like stopping, get, getting, run, running. Okay, so these are the rules you have to remember. Again, read this one. Verb of one syllable with one vowel and one consonant. Double the consonants. Okay, stop, stopping, get, getting, run, running. Now, if the final consonant is Y or W, it is not doubled, like playing Y and W. So there are exceptional rule. If the final consonant is Y or W, it is not doubled, like play, playing, show, showing. You understand? So see what else. So we have, I think for the grammar session, we'll do up to this, because if we do all of them, we might not remember, right? It might be burden. So we go to, we go back to a normal session now, and or maybe we just complete the state verbs part, okay? We'll complete up to this. The passive and present simple and present continuous passive, we'll do in another class. Let's do the state verbs. Is it getting too much? Or it's okay? Maybe we can go back to our normal class now. Okay, that's fine for today, for the grammar reference. Next class we'll start from here again. Just keep in mind, we'll start from here again, okay? All right, I'll just quickly mark here. We have finished up to here. Okay, good. Next class, we'll start from here. Now we'll go back to our normal lesson of Unit 3. It would be great if Mustafa could also join with us. But anyway, I think he's trying, but due to a technical problem, he's unable to join with us. That's not a problem. So in this session, we have like grammar, state, activity, verb, simple or continuous. So from here, we have learned simple or continuous tense, state, activity, verbs. We're going to learn in next class. And now we're going to this. So before we start this, we'll just get to know what we're going to learn in this lesson from a video. Let's watch a video now.
Okay. Said the sun doesn't come in.
Oh, is it? Okay, let me check. 1 second.
Active and passive forms.
Does it come down?
Yeah, now it's coming.
Welcome to Unit 3. I love my job, but sometimes it's quite stressful. Every evening I spend a lot of time preparing lessons and marking students' work. What's your job? Do you like it?
What's your job?
I'm a fashion designer.
Do you like it?
Yes, I really love it.
In this unit, we'll look at the simple and continuous tenses to describe facts, routines, or current activities. We'll also look at active and passive forms. In speaking and listening, you can try to guess which job goes with which salary. You'll listen to some people talk about their work and see if you can guess what their jobs are. You can also read a fascinating article about Dan Price, the best boss in America. Find out what makes him great and discuss what you think about his unique approach to running his company. In the writing section, you'll look at using formal language that will help you when you apply for a job by email or letter. You can go online to review material or to consolidate the language and skills from the unit. Are you ready? Let's get started.
All right. We have just listened to an introductory video regarding the unit where it shows that how and what we are going to learn in this unit. Now let's... So, choose a job you love and you never have to work a day in your life. Okay. Look at the photo. What's the man's job? Do you think he enjoys it? Why? Why not? Would you like to do it? So what do you think about this job? He's working in windows cleaning, 35th floor of the third London. Ali?
Yeah.
Look at the photo. What's the man's job? What job it is? Can you identify what he's doing?
This one, I think
window cleaning on 35th floor of the Sherat London. So he's doing or cleaning a window on the 35th floor. Can you imagine? On the 35th floor, he's doing that job. So
yeah.
Do you think he likes this job or enjoys this job? And why not? Would you like to do this job? What do you think?
Me.
Yes, tell me something.
Okay, me, I fear to cramp on the floor. It's not floor there. On the glass, because that this job is like, if you know how to clamp the wall. So
right.
For this one, it's not easy dangerous for me.
Yeah, that's right. So I think you wouldn't like that job. Neither I would. All right, let's move on. So here, how do you begin your day? What's your early morning routine till the class? Okay, tell me something about your day and what's your early morning routine? How do you begin your day? Please.
Okay. The morning when I wake up, brush my teeth. First, I'm going to pray. After prayers, I'm going to bath, then I prepare to go my work. So when I came to my workplace, I check all my tent in my office. After that, I receive the guests who come to me. After that, I take my dinner, then I relax. So, and then 3 o'clock in Ghana, so I start to join our learning group Zoom.
Good. So how do you begin your day? What's your early morning routine till the class? It is about how you begin your day. That's good. You start early in the morning with you finish your Fajr prayer, then get fresh, take your breakfast, get prepared for the job. Okay, that's good. Now we're going to listen a song. Listen carefully. Listen to a song called 9 to 5. Answer the questions. After listening this song, we will discuss how does the singer begin her day. So she will be telling us how does she begins her day in the morning. Does she enjoy her work? Why and why not? What's the rich man game? What do you think her job is? Okay, so try to guess, because the very first time it might not be 100% understandable. Try as much as you can. Let's try now.
3.1.
Stumble to the kitchen, I pour myself a cup of ambition. I yawn and I stretch and I try to come to life. Then I jump in the shower and the blood starts pumping. Out on the streets the traffic starts jumping, with folks like me on the job from 9 to 5. Working 9 to 5, what a way to make a living.
It.
Oh, wow.
All right. Now we try to understand what she wants to say in this song. How does the singer begin her day? Can you recall anything?
Okay.
Hard, isn't it?
The song it's not easy to remember again.
That's right, I understand. So no problem. Listen this song again on the recording, okay? And try to understand what it is there. We'll move forward.
Okay.
No problem. I understand you're from elementary level and it's the intermediate class. It can be a bit hard for you. That's fine. Now we are going to see this photo. Gary Rhodes, football manager, John Weber, head teacher, Onyx Baxter, he's a Royal Liverpool Hospital doctor, Kylie Cooper, deep sea diver. Look at the photos. Which jobs do you think are most or least stressful? Why? Which would you most least like to do and why? So see, based on this, which job do you think most stressful or less stressful? Which job do you think most or least stressful? What's your opinion, Mr. Ali?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So for me, I think a daughter.
Which one?
Daughter.
Doctor, okay.
Doctor.
Is it stressful or least stressful or most?
Because the daughter save so many people's life.
That's right.
So I think it's a job, a stressful job. Very for stressful. Me.
That's right. Yeah. Okay, good. And which one would be the next less or least stressful job, you think, out of the...
Okay. Okay, the second one for me, I would choose the football manager.
Is it, you think, that least stressful job?
Yes.
Okay, good. You have a good patience and people handling a skill. That's good.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
Because the because now the people like to watch a football, and they help the young boys to get jobs then to become a rich man, a rich man. So I think that one also is the stressful jobs.
Less stressful job. Okay.
Yeah.
So now we're going to work with a partner, ask and answer question about the people. What does Gary do? He's a football manager. What does he's doing in the picture? He's shouting at his team. Now, 3.2, we're going to listen audio over here. Listen to the four people talking about their jobs. After each one, answer the questions. What do they find stressful about their job? What do they do to relax or stay calm? What are they doing at the moment? Okay, so let's listen carefully. And in this, these four people will describe about their job and their stress, and they will show us the way how they, you know, come. Let's listen to this space.
3.2. How I Stay Calm by People in Stressful Jobs. 1. The Football Manager, Gary Rudd.
When I watch my team, my heart's racing, but I try to keep calm and not shout too much. I feel a huge responsibility for the club, and I have worries, injured players, referees I don't agree with. Also, I know that the manager is always blamed when the team loses. That's very stressful. The way I stay calm is to leave my work at work. I never watch the 24-hour sports channels. I don't go on social media and read what people say on Twitter or Facebook. I don't even talk to my family about it. And that's difficult when I'm down after a really bad game. Oh, and I do DIY around the house. I'm decorating the kitchen at the moment.
2. The head teacher, Joan Bevan.
I had the most fantastic teachers when I was at school, and I think that's why I feel so much stress and worry in this job. See, I believe that a good school makes a huge difference to the lives of young people. We have 1,100 students here, and I have a personal responsibility for each one of them. So I arrived early to school every morning to give myself time to just sit and think quietly. The most stressful situation is when angry parents show up. Oh, I try to stay calm, as the minute you shout, people don't listen. Also, I run. I'm training for the Great Welsh Marathon at the moment, so I run 8 miles 3 nights a week, and that's a great help.
3. The deep sea diver, Kyle Cooper.
What I do is install underwater gas and oil wells. I work 300 kilometres north of Shetland, in Scotland. The whole job is stressful, from the helicopter ride to the ship, to when I get into a 2.5 metre by 7 metre chamber for a month. I'm in there with 11 other divers. We work in teams of 3. We go up and down in a kind of diving bell, which is lowered to 20 metres above the seabed, and we work for 6 hours in the pitch black. It's tiring. It's very tiring. But I've been doing it for 20 years, and I still love it. Usually I work 1 month and then have 2 months off. Even when I'm not working, I love the sea. It calms me. You won't believe it, but sailing is my favourite pastime. I love sailing. I'm actually building my own boat at the moment.
4. The A&D doctor, Dr. Bonnie Baxter.
I'm an A&E doctor in a busy city centre hospital. We see about 60,000 patients a year. It's stressful most of the time, but especially weekends. We see twice as many patients at weekends. I understand their distress when they say, "How long do I have to wait? When will I be seen?" But I can't often give them an answer. The very nature of A&E is that it is unpredictable for both doctors and patients. I've now been working here almost 3 years. What helps me is having people around who share the stresses of the day. Oh, that and my knitting. In my few free moments, I knit. I'm making a little blue jacket for my sister's baby. He'll probably be too big for it by the time I finish.
All right, so we have listened. Lots of, and we heard a lot of things about them. Now, based on this listening, see if we can do something here. What do they find stressful about their job? What do they do relax or stay calm? What are they doing at the moment? So again, this interactive class, it would be great if you had more students in the class, so each one of them could join. Anyway, so can you recall anything from this conversation, from this speech, from these four people? Anything? Can you say something maybe? Ali, would you like to try?
Okay. I will try to talk about the teacher.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, teacher, he said they have remote 1,200 students in the class.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not easy to control all of them.
Yep.
Then, so she tried to manage them, to to educate them. So after the learning, she very tired. So I think it's not easy to all these old students in the class.
That's
so
right.
Sometimes, yeah, it's, sometimes she's very tired.
That's right.
Yeah.
Good try. All right, now we're going to do number 4, 3.2. Listen again and complete the sentence. What else can you remember about each person? So this time I'm not going to play full video together. I'm going to break it down into four, and we'll work on each of them, and we'll go for next, okay? For your convenience. And here, this is the use of our present simple and present continuous tense that we have just finished over there in grammar reference. So I want you to do a maximum and best usage of the tenses that we have learned. Okay, let's play this one.
3.2. How I stay calm.
Great.
By people in stressful jobs. 1. The football manager, Gary Rudd.
When I watch my team, my heart's racing, but I try to keep calm and not shout too much. I feel a huge responsibility for the club, and I have worries. Injured players, referees I don't agree with. Also, I know that the manager is always blamed when the team loses. That's very stressful. The way I stay calm is to leave my work at work. I never watch the 24-hour sports channels. I don't go on social media and read what people say on Twitter or Facebook. I don't even talk to my family about it. And that's difficult when I'm down after a really bad game. Oh, and I do DIY around the house. I'm decorating the kitchen at the moment.
2.
Okay, great. So now we're going to complete this. What will be here? I, what will be in the gap? Dash that manager dash. Can you recall something from the audio that you just listened?
Okay, so he says
this one, we're working on this. See, okay. I know that the manager I know that the manager dash always blamed when the team lose. Manager is in a passive form, okay? I know that the manager is always blamed when the team lose.
Number two,
I never dash the 24-hour sports. I never what? I never, see? Never, this is an adverb of frequency. Never. 0%, never. I never dash the 24 sports. I never what he can do with the sports. 24 sports, he can watch, right? So I never watch the 24 hours.
I never watch, yeah. Both.
Channel, I dash on social media. My dash, I don't go on social media. Number three, I dash DIY around the house. Do it yourself is DIY means. I dash DIY around the house. So what will be here, this one? Try to guess. Recall something maybe.
Okay, I am die around the house.
What did you say? Can you repeat, please?
I say I am die around the house.
All right, you're very close, but it wouldn't be I am. It will be I do.
DIY
around the house. I dash the kitchen at the moment. I am decorating the kitchen at the moment. They're missing word decorating. Okay. I am decorating the kitchen at the moment. Okay, good. We are going to listen, Mr. Juan. Now we try as much as we can. Before listening, maybe you can go through this word, like listening practice. Okay. That a good school a huge difference to live to the lives of young people. Number five, I dash for a great Wales marathon at the moment. So I dash 8 miles, 3 nights a week. Okay, remember these two sentences and we'll find out these sentences in our speech in the audio. Okay, let's play the audio now. Listen to this carefully, please.
The head teacher, Joan Bevan.
I had the most fantastic teachers when I was at school, and I think that's why I feel so much stress and worry in this job. See, I believe that a good school makes a huge difference to the lives of young people. We have 1,100 students here, and I have a personal responsibility for each one of them. So I arrived early to school every morning to give myself time to just sit and think quietly. The most stressful situation is when angry parents show up. Oh, I try to stay calm, as the minute you shout, people don't listen. Also, I run. I'm training for the Great Welsh Marathon at the moment, so I run 8 miles 3 nights a week, and that's a great help.
Three.
All right. Now, can you recall something and try to fill this gap, please? I dash that a good school dash a huge difference to the lives of young people. I dash for the Great Wales Marathon at the moment, so I dash 8 miles 3 nights a week. What will be the answer for this one? Anything you can remember?
Difficult.
All right, the answer will be, I believe that the good school makes a huge difference to the lives of young people. I training for the Great Wales Marathon at the moment, so I run 8 miles 3 nights a week. Okay, let's listen to the next one now.
Sea diver, Kyle Cooper.
What I do is install underwater gas and oil wells. I work 300 kilometres north of Shetland, in Scotland. The whole job is stressful, from the helicopter ride to the ship, to when I get into a 2.5 metre by 7 metre chamber for a month. I'm in there with 11 other divers. We work in teams of three. We go up and down in a kind of diving bell, which is lowered to 20 metres above the seabed, and we work for 6 hours in the pitch black. It's tiring. It's very tiring. But I've been doing it for 20 years, and I still love it. Usually I work 1 month and then have 2 months off. Even when I'm not working, I love the sea. It calms me. You won't believe it, but sailing is my favourite pastime. I love sailing. I'm actually building my own boat at the moment.
Four. The A&D.
Can you recall anything here too? We dash.
Okay. The first, we walk up and down.
We go well, up and down in a diving bell, which dash lower to the seabed. What will be this one? Even when I dash, not dash. Can you recall it?
Even when I'm not, working.
Mm-hmm. Working, I dash the sea. I what will be here? I love the sea, right? I love the sea. It what? It?
I love the sea.
It calms me. It calms
me. It calms me.
Okay. Number eight, I actually dash my own boat at the moment. What he's doing? He's doing something, at the moment. So I am actually building my own boat at the moment.
Boat.
So here you follow the tense is used here. I am actually building my own boat at the moment. Which tense it is in? Number eight.
Number eight. That is present tense.
Present, which tense? Present continuous. I am. See, the auxiliary verb used in I am. I am and verb has ing too. So it's a present.
Present continuous.
And this one, number seven.
Number seven.
Also present continuous, right?
Also present continuous.
That's right. Okay, let's listen to the last one about the Bonnie and we'll see.
Dr. Bonnie Baxter.
I'm an A&E doctor in a busy city centre hospital. We see about 60,000 patients a year. It's stressful most of the time, but especially weekends. We see twice as many patients at weekends. I understand their distress when they say, how long do I have to wait? When will I be seen? But I can't often give them an answer. The very nature of A&E is that it is unpredictable for both doctors and patients. I've now been working here almost 3 years. What helps me is having people around who share the stresses of the day. Oh, that and my knitting. In my few free moments, I knit. I'm making a little blue jacket for my sister's baby. He'll probably be too big for it by the time I finish.
Okay, let's listen. Can you guess what it'll be? There is distress. I understand their distress. In my few free moments, I making a little blue jacket for my sister baby.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so now from here, I want to read from 1 to 10 and exactly tell me which one. Which sentence is belong to which tense? Start from one place. You need to explain me which tense this belongs to. We have learned so far present simple, present continuous. Also, we know a bit of about present simple passive that we have done before. So explain me, please. I mean, just tell me which tense it is and why. Because each tense has a identical verb and auxiliaries. So by this, you need to identify and let me know, please. Okay, go through by one by one.
Okay. I start the one.
Yep.
I know that the manager is always blames when the team loses. That sentence is past tense.
No, past tense. How do you know it's past tense?
Because I know that manager is always blames. Blames is past tense. When the team loses.
All right, let me explain. I understand your point of view. See, I know that the manager, first of all, this is one sentence. I know that the manager, I know it is a sentence. It is in present simple that the manager is always blamed. So this is in present simple passive voice, in a voice, okay? Manager is always blamed. When we use the voice, the be verb is used before the object, after the object, and the verb become past participle, and that's why you thought it would be a past tense, but actually it is not. See, the verb is.
Yeah.
But we'll know more about this was next class because we haven't done that much data. When the
people Number two. I never watch the 24 hours sports channel. So that one is the present tense.
That's right. Present, which one?
Present tense. Watch.
Present, which
watch
one?
Is present.
Present, simple tense. Present?
Yeah, simple. Present simple. Present simple, yeah. Present simple. Then channel and I don't go on social media. I don't go to social media. That means the present. This is negative or present. Present simple.
That's right. Yeah. Beautiful. Yep. Next one. Number three.
So I do die around the house.
DIY around the house.
Yeah, they also, I do also present simple.
Very good, present simple. Next one.
Yeah, and I'm the kitchen at moment.
So it will be, I'm decorating. The missing word is decorating. I am decorating.
Which I am decorating.
Yep.
I am decorating, that means the present continue.
Beautiful, why?
Because I am.
Yes, because there is a be verb, am, and also the verb with ing. And that's the structure, as we know, that subject plus be verb, am, is, are, depending on the subjective pronoun, then verb with ing is the sign of present continuous tense. Okay, good.
Yes.
Now, number four, try number four, please.
Number four, I believe that a good school makes. I believe. Mm-hmm. Present simple.
Present simple, yeah.
I believe that a good school makes a young difference to the lives of young people.
That's good. So you got the right one. Present simple, which has a normal subject with present from a verb plus object. Good. Number five.
I'm training is a present continuous.
Present continuous. Good.
I'm training for the Great Welsh Marathon at the moment. So I run 8 men's 3. Iran is the present simple.
Good. Iran is the present simple. Very beautiful. Number Kelly, start from 6, please.
Okay. Number six. We go up and down. We go is the present simple.
Mm-hmm.
Present simple. We go up down in the divine belief, which is also present simple.
No. So which is lower to see bad? It is in passive form. We avoid this one. We'll learn this one next class. Which is lower to see bad? So which is the here object? Is the be verb. Lower is a past participle form to be a passive form. We'll teach you that one next class. Let it go for now. Go for the number 7. But it is in passive form.
It's okay. Even when I'm not working, I'm not working is present continuing.
That's right. And why?
Because working.
Because there is a be verb am, and also the verb is ing formed, like working.
Yeah. Okay. I
so
ing. Yeah.
So you have to identify the sentence or tense by looking at the be verb or the auxiliary verb and the main verb. Okay, that's how you identify. Okay. Good. Next okay. one.
So I love the sea is calm. I love is the present simple.
Present simple, yep.
The sea is calm. Calm also is present simple.
Why it is added S? The comes has S. Why?
Yeah. S because...
because the subject is because third person singular number. As you know,
yeah.
he, yeah. she, it, any names, they are third person yeah. singular number. And when it is yeah. third person singular number, verb it's comes or add are S, which is S.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. good. Next, number eight, please.
I'm actually breathing. Mm-hmm. Is present simple.
No.
Present simple.
I'm actually building, yeah. building, ing from verb, building, build, from build, building. My own boat
building also is present continuous.
That's right. So you have to look at the auxiliary and you have to look at the main verb form, okay?
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah.
Go for nine number, please.
I understand their distress. Mm-hmm. So that is present simple. I understand.
That's right. Number 10. Present. Good.
Yeah. So, and in my few free moment, nicked. This also is the present simple, and I'm making also is present continuous because and the end of making ing.
That's right. Beautiful. You have got it yeah. now. Now, based on the present continuous and present simple, I want you to make five sentences of present simple, five sentences of present continuous, and that's all for the day. We finished for the day. Can you please try? Five sentences. Okay. Five sentences in present simple.
Okay. I going to home every 5 o'clock.
I go to home every day at 5 o'clock. I go to yeah. home. So, yep, yeah. one next one.
So, I play football with my friends.
Good, yep.
Mm-hmm. I eat with my sister.
Okay, good. What do you eat? I eat rice.
I eat rat with my sister, yeah.
Okay, good. Two more.
I work for 24 hours.
You work for 24 hours, 7 days or 5 days? How many days?
3 days.
3 days, 24 hours. Are you serious? Okay, next one. That's
okay.
fine.
Okay, I done for the present tense.
Okay, good. Now present continuous. Five.
Present continuous.
Continuous. Present?
Yeah, I'm eating fufu. Hmm? I'm eating fufu.
Okay.
Okay.
Present continuous. You have four more to go.
I am going to school.
You're going to school? Good.
Yeah. I'm talking with my teacher. My teacher.
That's good. Yep. Good example.
Yeah. I'm doing
What are you doing?
Okay. I'm doing...
You're doing an English course. You're doing English...
Yeah, I'm doing an English course.
Yep.
No. So I'm reading...
Anything English what you're doing now, you can yeah. say in this tense.
Yeah, I'm reading English books.
You're reading English books. Okay.
I am planning to go to market.
You're planning to go to market? Yep. Near future one. Good.
I am speaking English.
You are speaking in English.
In good. English, okay.
Very good. So, yeah, so go through this video again, which will be published in our Facebook page. And share also, you know, share the video so that it is this knowledge, this classes is shared to other people also, and they can get benefited too.
Okay.
All right, you have done a wonderful job. That's all for today. Do you have any questions based on this learning grammar or anything? If you have any question, you can ask me.
No, for the present tense and the present continuum, I don't have the questions.
Good. So you're clear now about present simple and present continuous. Now, you know, the good thing, only using these two sentences in our day-to-day life, you can make lots of sentences and you can do literally communicate. These are the two sentences, okay. Very essential that most of the speech, most of the conversation can be made and finished with these two tense and two sentence structure. It's very, very essential. So if you remember these two, in the day-to-day life, you can use them a lot. Okay?
Okay.
So do more practices. Now, you know this structure with this one. Try to speak. So whatever you learn here, but to be fluent in English, you have to do a practice. And when you do okay. practice, you'll do make mistake and don't worry about doing mistakes. Okay, okay. Through mistakes you can learn. Everyone does the mistake. Even a native speaker, they do lots of mistakes in their speaking. So do I. Okay. I do make mistakes too, but that's okay. Okay. All right, that's okay. all for the lesson. Thanks for your time. I'll catch you up tomorrow in our elementary English language course. Thank you very much. Have a wonderful night. Bye for now.
Okay. Same to you, Sid.
Thank you.
See you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow.